Rescue teams have shifted to search and retrieval operations in the boat tragedy in the town of Binangonan in Rizal. The boat capsized Thursday, killing at least 26 people. The mishap happened hours after Typhoon Egay left the Philippine area of responsibility. The Philippine Coast Guard blames the captain of the boat Aya Express for allowing over 60 passengers in the boat, despite its 42-seating capacity. Coast Guard personnel at the Binangonan port will be relieved and will also face a probe.
Oras ng biyahe na doon po nagsubmit ng manifest yung captain.
Opo.
Doon po sa station ng Coast Guard at sinasabi niya nga po na 22 lang yung pasahero. Pero sabi rin po nung kapitan, inadmit niya rin po na pagkatapos po nilang mag-submit sa Coast Guard at mag-attest na 22 lang yung pasahero ay nagpasakay pa po yung mga crew nila ng maraming pasahero at bago sila umalis. May tagubilin po tayo at palagi nating binibrief yung mga boat operators at mga may-ari na palagi pong mag-submit ng tamang manifesto at magpasuot ng life jacket kapag sila po ay naglalayag. Yung crew po ay hinahanap po sa Talib Island at yung mga personnel naman po ng Philippine Coast Guard ay nasa ilalim din po ng investigation.
40 other passengers have been rescued. The Maritime Industry Authority suspended the safety certificate of the capsized vessel. A survivor claims the delayed response of rescue teams is among the reasons many died in the Rizal boat tragedy. Recalling the fatal incident, Mar de los Reyes says rescuers failed to arrive on time to save passengers who were trapped inside the vessel.
Almost 30 minutes na kami nasa may taas ng bangka. Wala pang tulong.
Wala pang tulong?
Opo. Tapos nagkaya niya lang po yung mga taga Kalinawan. Yung sa bakay Kalinawan, may liit na bangka, nagsuguran, yun po unang tumulong. Dumating po yung mga rescue, almost 1.5 hours na, almost 2 hours na.
Okay,
wala
so...
Wala pong silang nagatnan. Kaya wala pong tag-room, na-revive, wala po.
Wala.
Talagang lahat patay.
De Los Reyes also claims Coast Guard personnel did not check their boat before they set sail. Over in Cagayan, search efforts are underway for 4 missing rescuers of the Philippine Coast Guard after their boat capsized off Abulug. The rescuers were on their way to help crew members of a private tugboat when their own vessel overturned in rough seas Wednesday. The Coast Guard Aviation Force will deploy additional assets to help the search efforts.
2 days ago po ay nakatanggap ng tawag po yung aming station sa Cagayan na mayroong isang tugboat na na-stranded at tinatangay ng hinahampas ng malakas na alon doon po sa Puerto Aparino, bahagi ng Cagayan River. At mayroon daw pong kailangan i-rescue na isang inatake sa puso na crew, kaya pinuntahan po ng 2 teams ng Philippine Coast Guard. Unfortunately po, yung isang team ay nakalapit pero tinamaan ng malakas na alon at pumaog. Samantalang nag-backout na po yung isang rescue team. Pagkatapos po noon ay hindi na po nakita yung isang rescue team at tinangay na po ng alon. At ang huling sightings po ay nakakapit yung mga tawanan ng Philippine Coast Guard doon sa aluminum boat na ginamit nilang pang-rescue.
Police will be going to Talim Island to interview victims and relatives of those who died in the Rizal boat tragedy. Now, our correspondent Vivian Gulia joins us for that story. Hi, Viv. What are they expecting to find there?
Hi, Stanley. Well, police inspectors are on their way to villages in Talim Island where many of the passengers of the motor bangka that capsized off Binangonan and Rizal yesterday reside. They will interview victims' families as well as survivors to get an account of the incident. Earlier today, we also interviewed a survivor, 25-year-old Mar de los Reyes, and he told us that when MV Princess Aya left the port in Binangonan and Rizal, there was no rain, but around 45 minutes into their travel to Talim Island, de los Reyes said fierce waves caused an outrigger to snap, which triggered panic among passengers who then crowded to one side of the vessel. This caused the vessel to tilt and eventually to turn upside down. De los Reyes said the number of life vests he saw inside the vessel was less than the number of passengers. that he noted that the tarpaulin trapped on the side and sides and rear of the wooden vessel to prevent passengers from getting wet by the rain was what made it more difficult for many to jump from or leave the capsized vessel. De Los Reyes said he was just fortunate to see a small opening between the tarpaulin, which he ripped to stay afloat. He also received help from a fellow passenger. De Los Reyes sustained a minor wound, but is now better. De Los Reyes added that it took around 30 minutes before rescuers arrived at the scene of the incident. According to authorities, 26 people died, while 40 more survived. The captain of the vessel admitted that only 22 people listed down their names on the passenger manifest, and that included De Los Reyes, whom we interviewed earlier. Search and rescue efforts continued this morning, but Barangay Kalinawan Chairman Virgilio Cerda said that the captains of six villages in Talim Island have yet to receive new reports on missing passengers from MV Princess Aya. That's the latest from here. Stanley, back to you.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Vivian Gulia. At least 13 are reported dead due to Typhoon Egay. Data from the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council also show 20 more are reported missing. The storm affected over 500,000 individuals, with more than 42,000 displaced. Meanwhile, the estimated cost of damage to infrastructure has jumped to over 656 million pesos. Damage to agriculture was pegged at around 58 million. Those numbers are expected to go higher. The province of Cavite is the latest to declare a state of calamity in the aftermath of Egay. The new tropical storm outside the Philippine area of responsibility has maintained its strength. Our resident meteorologist Ariel Rojas now joins us with the latest on the weather. Hi, Ariel.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon. Despite not having any storms within our territory, the southwest monsoon or Habagat will bring rains over the northern and western parts of the country this weekend. Typhoon Doksuri, locally called Egay, has made landfall over Fujian province in southeastern China and is not affecting the country anymore. Meanwhile, the tropical depression east of the country intensified into a tropical storm early morning Friday and was given the international name Kanun. Tropical storm Kanun was last spotted 1,345 kilometers east of Visayas, with maximum winds of 65 kilometers per hour and gustiness up to 80 kilometers per hour. It is currently moving north-northwestward at a speed of 25 kilometers per hour. Kanun is forecast to enter the Philippine area of responsibility between Saturday evening and Sunday morning with typhoon strength. It will be assigned the local name Falcon. It will remain in the middle of the sea, or the Philippine Sea, and will not approach nor hit the country. However, it will also pull the Habagat. The typhoon will be out of the country by Monday. This Friday, monsoon rains are still affecting western Pangasinan, central Luzon, Cavite, Batangas, Mimaropa, and western Visayas. There will also be scattered rains in Cordillera, the rest of Ilocos and Calabarzon, and Sulu Archipelago. This weekend, monsoon rains will continue to batter the western sections of central Luzon, Calabarzon, Mimaropa, and western Visayas. Intense thunderstorms will affect the entire Luzon and eastern Visayas Saturday afternoon and northern and central Luzon Sunday afternoon. Flooding and landslides continue to threaten these areas, especially those heavily affected by Egay. And here in Metro Manila, it will be mostly cloudy this weekend with some sunny spells. Rains are expected early morning, mid-afternoon, and in the evening. That's the latest on the weather. Happy weekend and stay dry and safe, everyone. Back to you, Sandy.
All right. Thank you and stay dry too, Ariel. Power transmission operations in Luzon now back to normal. This after the National Grid Corporation of the Philippines completed the restoration of lines affected by Typhoon Egay. Among the areas that were energized is Baguio, which suffered a near citywide blackout at the height of the storm. Egay damaged dozens of homes in Abra, where some areas are still without power. Bianca Dava now joins us with the latest from Abra. Good afternoon, Bianca. What do you know so far?
Stanley, weather is a lot better here in Bangkat Abra this morning. As you can see here behind me, some residents are slowly returning to their homes here in Barangay Santa Rosa, which is one of the villages that was submerged in flood during the onslaught of Super Typhoon Egay. The flood has subsided in most parts of Bangued, but when the powerful typhoon slammed Abra on Wednesday, the heavy rains it brought caused floods which trapped some residents on roofs. Not only did Egay sweep away people's belongings, it also destroyed rice and corn fields, which are sources of livelihood of residents. People have now slowly returned to their flooded homes to clean what's left of their belongings and see what can still be used. Mud-covered chairs, cabinets, washing machines, and beds are piled up here on the streets as residents sweep debris and murky water from their houses. People have also started returning their animals to the villages after finding refuge for them in the streets near the town center. The Abra Provincial Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Office, or PDRIMO, said more than 17,000 families, or 15,000 or 59,000 individuals rather, are affected by Super Typhoon Egay here in the province. In its assessment on Thursday, the typhoon damaged over 120 houses. Aside from the flood, multiple landslides were also recorded in Abra. Various government agencies are now clearing roads of fallen trees and electric posts. Power lines are still down here in the province, with the Abra provincial capital serving as the charging station of residents. Stanley, on July 27 last year, the province of Abra was struck by a magnitude 7 earthquake. And a year later, residents here are facing difficulties again, this time with the effects of Super Typhoon Egay. Now, aside from the relief packs from the government, some private individuals have also visited barangays here in Bangued, Abra to personally give assistance in the form of food, water to those affected. Stanley?
Yes, Bianca, we know for a fact that relief operations are essential in this type of disaster where you have a lot of towns or even villages that are still isolated because of landslides and even floods. What more can you tell us about clearing operations of the government? When do they expect at least to finish the clearing operations? And perhaps how many more towns are we talking about when you say isolated by floods and landslides?
Stanley, according to the Abra PDRRMO, they have monitored 3 major landslides and 22 minor landslides, including rock slides and swollen creeks here in the province of Abra. But so far, all the roads which are affected by the landslides are passable at this time. Motorists should only expect that there should be a moderate traffic in these areas because government agencies are still doing the clearing operations to remove the fallen electric posts and trees in these areas. As to the isolated areas, according to the Abra PDRRMO, so far they have already reached all the areas which were also flooded during the onslaught of the typhoon.
Okay, let's talk about the blackouts now. The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines has said it has, significantly restored power in a lot of areas in Luzon, particularly in Baguio City. But in Abra, you were saying there are still a lot of areas without power. How many areas do we are we talking about here?
Well, Stanley, according to the Abra PDRRMO, the whole province is still without power. In fact, today they will be having a meeting with the Abra Electric Cooperative to see when can the power lines or the power supply be restored at the earliest possible time.
All right. Bianca Dava there reporting to us from Abra. Thanks, Bianca.